Udom is a long-term practitioner from the community who was at Citi for a number of years doing as a global head of cloud financial management. And he was so excited about this focus project, was in the working group, that he actually decided to leave Citi. And he's now actually joined the Linux Foundation full-time with us to help push this forward. So we're so honored to have Udom on the team with us now. And thank you for taking this leap and for helping to push forward this project. And we'd love to hear what you're working on with it.
Thank you, JR. My name is Udom. I've been in this space for a while. Looked at this problem set from, this is the fourth lens through which I'm looking at it. Worked at a cloud vendor, then cost management vendor, then at Citi running cloud financial management, and now joining the foundation primarily to work on focus, as JR said. So when we say focus, we're not yelling at you to pay attention, by the way. We just try and tell you about this this specification. So as you see here, it is an open source specification for cloud billing data. So we're sort of working from the output and then working backwards from there. The output is really a FinOps serviceable data format. Many of you are consumers of the billing data, and many of you, as we see in the chat and everything, are very passionate about the billing data and being able to extract value out of it. We're working from that backwards to figure out what needs to be in the data in terms of dimensions and metrics and attributes. Then we're trying to get that into a vendor-neutral cross-cloud schema. And more importantly, we're also trying to get that terminology to be aligned with FinOps. Obviously, there's this great framework, the books, the trainings, et cetera. We really need the cloud billing data to line up with what we learn in FinOps. So that's a big goal here as well. As you can see, this is for both sides of this, this equation. One side is the cost data producers. So your cloud and SaaS providers that generate cost and usage data. And then on the other side are the consumers, as well as the cost management vendors that try to provide insights from this data. This is a brand new project under the Linux Foundation. It's sponsored by the FinOps Foundation. If you recall, there was a open billing working group last year. We paused that. We handed over all that work to this new project. And many of the staff members here, JR and Mike and Rob and Vaz and others, have spent countless days, forming this this new entity, primarily for the purpose of ensuring that there's a free open source specification for all parties to use, the vendors and providers that generate this data, as well as organizations and consumers of the data that want to use it. So that's a very important part for us. Next slide, please. So why focus? Like I said, I think all the folks that went before me made probably a better case than I can make. But I'll summarize it this way. We're trying to build trust in the cost and usage data or billing data because your organizations want to make value-based judgments or decisions about using cloud, about how much cloud, about what to use cloud on, et cetera. And in order to do that, they need a comprehensive view that about your cost and usage of using cloud to make those decisions. Secondly, our FinOps practitioners' lives are very complicated today, as Sanjana just highlighted. It's impacted by the complexity and the inconsistency in the data. So, and that complexity and inconsistency grows linearly as you add more vendors or providers. And that's a fairly common thing. As your organization matures, you're gonna use more providers, but also you want to make decisions based on broader information, Lauren made a very good presentation and case for, including all the shared components. And I saw somebody ask, what about labor costs and et cetera. So your organization as a mature is going to want to make these decisions, not just based on one cloud vendor's billing data, but the overall picture. So that's where we come in. And again, I don't need to make the case here that many of you have called that this is a problem that you face in terms of driving FinOps in your organization. So here's a visual representation of what I'm talking about. As you see up top, you're getting this different proprietary formats and schema and terminology, and the burden is on the practitioner to try to do some magic and put this together. In the future, this is what it, we think this is going to look like, where many vendors will lean in, the providers will lean in and produce the data in focus specification. If you're a brand new provider, you're probably just going to adopt this specification rather than try to create yet another proprietary way of providing the billing data. If you're an existing vendor, you're probably looking to incorporate this into your billing data and cost management capabilities today. And some set of providers may not adopt the specification, and that's okay. We will have the ability to use our FinOps community and the broader community to create open source connectors that convert the data into the focus specification, so we can still get the benefit of a lot of the normalization. That's kind of the reasoning. And I can tell you firsthand, I mean, this is the problem that I was solving at Citi the last few years. We had a broad platform across multiple cloud vendors, SaaS vendors, licensing and other internal costs. And our thousands of applications that want to use cloud, they wanted a overall visibility, a single bill for their usage, not to do cost management on every single vendor individually. So hopefully this is a common problem that many of you are facing as well, and we'll get a benefit through this specification. Next slide. Just tell you a little bit about the roadmap. As I mentioned, the team's been working really hard to get focus stood up. We have the steering committee formed as of March, working groups. So then we started working on the contract license, contributor license agreement. That got published last week. We've had, I think, 7 or 8 people that have already gone through the process and gotten their approvals. There's probably a dozen or more people that are currently going through the process. So a lot of interest. We've kicked off the first working group earlier this week. There's another meeting happening today to work on this stuff. And we're kicking off a second group most likely next week. Both these groups will be working on this initial 0.5 release that we're targeting for FinOps X. That is targeting a lot of cost reporting and chargeback use cases. So I saw the discussion earlier about amortized and using that for chargeback and all that kind of stuff. These are exact problems that we're trying to make sure we solve with the specification. So we're starting with the cloud service providers costs, and then for V1.0 and beyond, it's really about expanding beyond cost reporting and chargeback to other FinOps capabilities, as well as adding support for more data providers, so SaaS costs, third party and internal costs, et cetera. Next slide. And finally, how to get involved. Just the same pitch as what's been said before. These are the early days of this specification. It's a great opportunity to get involved and really start helping to form what the specification is doing, what problems it solves, and how we end up solving those things. We are on GitHub. That's where you can see our progress, see our issues that we're working on, how it's organized into versions, et cetera. The contributor license agreement, that's an important part. That's also in GitHub. This is necessary because this is a closed group for contribution because we want to ensure that that whole royalty-free specification. So your employer will need to provide you an authorization to come contribute to the specification. Connect with us on chat-focus and our website. We just updated a bunch of content there yesterday. So yeah, super excited to see all of you get involved and contribute. Thank you.
JR here from the FinOps Foundation. Thank you for watching. Please go to finops.org if you want to get plugged into this amazing community. And of course, hit subscribe right here on YouTube to get all the future content. Hope to see you soon.